How's it going, everybody? This is Eddie, and I got another episode of the Let's Play for you here today. And today, I think in the last episode I went over what we were going to do today, but I quite frankly don't remember what I said, and also decided that number one should probably be the floor, because at this point, mostly it's just making sure everything looks aesthetically good in the palace here. And then it's a matter of, you know, putting in everything like furnaces, storage room, everything like that. So I figured if we're going to be dealing with the looks of everything, we would most likely want to have a good floor so that everything doesn't look ugly. So that's what we're doing. And do I have any more? No. So the first thing I want to do is these smooth stone half slabs. We're going to double them up and we'll see how that is. I think I got more smooth stone over here. And no, it's in here. Oh, there's always villagers in here. And I kind of have to let them go out on their own. Because if I don't, then the iron golems will be pissed. So, ugh. Anyways, let's see how many half slabs this gets us. Stack and a half should get us 3 stacks. Is that going to be enough? It's more like a stack and a half of space, because that's how many blocks we have. What do we have in here? Nothing good. So, yeah, we're going to have to get more. Probably about, yeah, all right. So heading back to the ravine to get more, and we're gonna do the floor. I want to do some pixel art on the floor. I haven't decided what yet, though. Something that's not gonna be in your face, but also is gonna, you know, be a nice design. I was thinking, this is what I want. Is that gonna be enough? And then we'll take this too. Yeah. I was thinking, I usually do one of the things I like to do with pixel art is mob faces, but I don't know of a mob that would be good. I like the slime face, but I already have one of those, and I don't think that would really match. Chicken, sheep, enderman. I'm not really big on pixel art. It's just, you know, just nice, I guess. I don't know. I like it. So I was thinking maybe, I had an idea before, but I lost it, and I remember that I didn't particularly like it either. It's just a thought. Oh, also I did a design that I think works pretty well with the fences. I don't know if mobs can get in this. I think they can. But, it's kind of hidden. I like it like that. And this one is probably going to be the nether portal. I think I already said that. Right there. And then we could knock this out right here. So we could just go into the house from the nether portal, or we could leave from the nether portal. Let's put that back, though. I didn't really want to do that, because I haven't decided on that yet. Diagonal doors are always a challenge. But then this other side actually is going to lead right up into the wall here. So this can be something like either a secret passageway or possibly a stairwell or something. And I still haven't done this wall or the other one that's here, but in the tower over there. So yeah, those are things to do. Or the floors here either, but I haven't decided what they're gonna be. This floor in here might be grass. I don't know yet. I like the way grass looks, even in the desert. So, I'm gonna brainstorm. I'm gonna do this off camera. I'm doing the rim first, just to see, 'cause I honestly really like this block. And I was going to make it all half slabs, but the problem is that, or just do this so that it wouldn't take so long, right? But then every chest and crafting table and furnace is gonna be up a block. So then underneath, so that it's not floating, we're gonna have to do this on them, but then some of them will be raised, some of them won't be, and it's just a little inconvenient. And I happen to, these aren't hard to get, these slabs. It's smooth stone, which, I have plenty of and can get plenty of, and just turned into half slabs. So I figured I could, and also then the pixel art, if the pixel art wasn't made with some kind of a half slab, it would be either sticking under the ground or sticking above the ground, which would be really annoying. So I figured it was probably worth it to getting frame rate problems. I don't know. It's a new version of, yeah, it definitely is. Oh, look at that. Wow. New version of Fraps, so. It seems like turning down a normal render distance tends to solve the problem, so maybe it's not Fraps' fault. Maybe it is, I don't know. Because I think Fraps is affecting Java, and so that means it's slowing Java down, and then so when Java slows down, Minecraft runs slower. So I think that's why that's doing that. All right, anyways, like I said, oh, actually, you know what? What about a striped pattern on the floor? And then with like smooth stone in between. That could look good. Yeah. So, wait. Of course, I don't have smooth stone. I do have coal on me, so maybe it would be worth it to make a furnace in this area. Of course, I don't have a lot of coal, but that's fine. So let's make a little bit. Let's just try with like 16. And so yeah, I'll lay this out now. And the other thing is that, oh, too deep. Oh. Wait, how did this one go? There, there. Alright, so this could make a pattern to determine the size of our gold pyramid. I have thought about it, and I think it should be a pyramid, not a cone. A cone would probably look silly, I think. So, I hate how I have an odd number of these. Anyways, so let's see what we're at here. Is that enough? I like that. And then I'll, so okay. Jesus, the frames. Yeah, that makes sense too, 'cause the version of Fraps that I'm using now allows me to record, like before Fraps would stop recording after 4 GB, I think, of video is recorded. So with Minecraft, that's like, I'm actually not sure how long each little clip would be. So now I think it slows down Minecraft after it goes over 4 GB. And I could turn that off, but oh, I'm gonna get more coal. But it makes editing so much easier, so I'm gonna see if if I can get this to work nicely. But you can tell me if you think render distance on far, like if you seeing that fog in the distance actually does make a difference, then to you, then I would be happy to change that. Because it doesn't, you know. I will edit, do more editing if people want me to do more editing. I'm not that lazy, it's just, you know. Yeah, you get the point. But also, since I do have the ability to make my clips longer than whatever it is where it reaches the 4 gigabyte mark, I kind of want to utilize that, so that's why I didn't do that off camera, even though I said I would. So I'm thinking, I will go off camera for this though, so the episode stays short. I'm thinking, I'm just trying to mark these, put it right there too, right here, here and here we make, we do this, so that what we can do then is make this whole place that's not this one square, and then that can be our space for the pixel art if we choose to do that, or we could just do a pattern like we did here. So now I will be back with you after I finish doing exactly what I just said. Alright guys, so I have finished it. I have put the walls in here and made this a perfect square. And we have 14 by 14 area, which is great. And I'm thinking what we should put in the center is some kind of an item. So, you know, like bread, or like this kind of a picture here, which I think is 16 by 16. It could be a block, I guess, right? Or, no, well, wait, no. It can't be 16, it has to be 8 by 8. What was another item that I put? Oh, it was a potion thing. Now, I don't know if people are going to think it's unfair of me to go into creative mode to scroll through the item list to see which one we want to do. But I don't think that's unfair, but I do not want to risk people saying, you know, you're cheating because you went into creative mode, even though you'd probably see that I didn't take anything from there. So to eliminate any confusion, I'm going to head over into the creative flat world for a second, and then I will be back in here in a moment to actually once we have the item decided. So one second. Alright guys, here we are. Now sorry, it's nighttime. Oh, I'm getting great frames here, so maybe it's SMP and recording thing. Anyways, so sorry it's nighttime, but all we need to look at is in here to figure out which one's gonna look the best. A diamond, those colors will look out of place, I think. Gold ingot might work. Let's put that on the hotbar to remember it. Glowstone dust is probably too detailed. See, this one we can probably get away with a lower resolution on. Like, for instance, where is it? This one was small. Spider eye. We're not going to make a spider eye. Gas tier. That's one we could easily pull off. I don't know if it has any meaning, though. Ooh, an arrow. One thing I wanted to do was put like an arrow going one way and a gold sword going the other way. Go away. Alright, I hope you can oh, damn. See this even though it's nighttime. I think they're bigger when oh, nope, no! Alright, let's try this again. Damn. Not that one. Oh god, I'm such a fail. Missing the gold ingot, but alright, gas tier really easy. This one might not fit one way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That one might fit, actually. This one definitely won't fit the gold sword. And the arrow definitely won't either, which is unfortunate, because I liked that idea. But that's fine. So let's see if I can toss this one out. Yep. Will that one fit? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Oh, maybe not. Gas tier would definitely fit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3, which would stop bobbing up and down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's 5 by 8. That would totally fit. I don't know why the hell you would have a gas tier. Like, they don't mean anything. It's just potion for regeneration, right? And it's not a potions room, it's an entire palace, so I don't know about the glass bottle. I kind of like the idea of gas tier. Snow, white wool, gray wool, and black wool, looks like, or maybe gray wool, like dark gray. Oh, come on. It might be what we want there. Stop. Trying to get a good look at it, but you can't get too close. Oh, man. I guess we could try it. And if this doesn't look good or if it's just dumb, then we will switch to just a pattern on the floor. So I will be right back with you. Alright guys, looks like we have to go on a little bit of a squid hunt. And I thought I would share with you a couple of things, one of which being a villager from the village all the way over there has wandered quite a distance. Yeah, so I'm gonna leave him there, but sucks to be him. Anyways, the other thing I would like to fill you in on, none of you will probably care, but it is an idea that I had for... Is that some squid? I can't see. I don't think so. It is an idea that I had for a mod, but of course I think every mod is basically an idea for the full game. Now I haven't been in this area for too long, so squid shouldn't really be spawning yet, I guess. There's some over there. It is an idea for a mod and an idea for the game. I think that it would be a great addition to the game. I also think it would have been a better addition before the UR Minecraft project, seeing as it pertains to pixel art and whatnot. So, when you put a rose in your crafting table, which is the way to get red dye, you get 2, do I have bones meal on me? Oh god, I don't. Alright, so we're just gonna have to collect a whole crap ton and then put it on later since I can't see how many I have. You get 2 red dye, yeah. And then, you know, you put that red dye with some yellow dye and get orange dye. And that's how it currently works. And you can only use as many colors as there are different wool colors. So currently, as far as I know, the only way to get for Mojang or, you know, a mod or anything like that to add different colors of wool. And this mod may already exist, I don't know. But the only way for them to get different colors of wool and stuff is would if you were to add new wool blocks with different colors, which is stopping them from getting you know, to have every available color or every major available color using like the RGB, you know, red, green, blue. If you mix different, is 7 gonna be enough? Let's just head over here and see if we can get any more. Yeah, this fog actually kind of annoys me now too. So up there's Rob's boat. No squid. Alright, I'm just gonna head back and see how far 7 gets us. Because we're gonna be using this with bone meal, so we're actually gonna get 14. And we already have 6 gray, because I already had some gray wool. No squid. I hope 14 is enough. Oh wait, I know if 14 is enough. Yeah, we only need 10. That's good. Okay, good. What was I saying now? Squid in here? Oh, right, mod idea. So, I was thinking a nice mod would be like a little addition to the engine where, to the game engine, where a block can have a different, because, you know, a block can have like a different texture, but it wouldn't be like an actual texture like it would be in a texture pack. It would be, you map the pixels of the texture to different colors based on a starting color. So, for instance, if you start with the color red, all red, no green, no blue, then bone meal down there. Then it'll be, let's place a block of wool so I can show this. This pixel would be slightly darker than red. This pixel would be even less slightly darker than red. This would be a lot darker red. This would be pure red. This one would be, and then you can create the texture that way, pixel by pixel. And then what that would allow you to do is you could start from a different base color. So then if you put a rose in your crafting table, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm not gonna do it more than I need. Then if you put a rose in your crafting table, you could get 50 red dye, and when you right-click on a wool, then you add that much of that of a color. And then if you need to start over, so like if you accidentally add too many reds and your color becomes too, and basically then you would, if you get like 50 red dyes, and then out of, I think it's 255 is like the RGB scale for every color, so then by adding a green dye and a blue dye and a red dye, you can get every single color possible. So you'd have to look up how much red and add that many dyes to your wool, and then how much green, add that many, how much blue, add that many, and then you'd get any color possible. So you could do any color of wool. But the problem, you know what's going to happen? I don't know why this one didn't grow, so I'll just do that. Then we're almost done. Yay. Let's do this. And snow is good. What was this one? Light gray. Good. So I think this should be enough. I'm going to need one. Because you do this. And then you get gray, right? And then you get 4 of them. I'm going to need one more. Come on. There we go. And then do that and we get 8. How many did I need? 6. Perfect. So now we have everything to try out the gas tier. I hope this works. Just put the shears in there for some reason. I got the shears in case I needed to use the sheep that I have so far. Also, I should mention my plan. So, anyways, that's my to finish my other thought. That's my plan, or not my plan. My idea for a Minecraft mod. It would be like a two spiders reworking of the wool texture system, so that it would allow basically for you to have a massive amount of dyes, but each one of those dyes increments the value of the RGB color of the wool by one, thus allowing for every single color. I moved all my stuff in here. Damn spider. Oh, spiders can't get in there. It's a plus, I guess. And take a sleep, and let's do this pixel art. Gonna have to find the center of the picture though. 2, 3, 2, 3. That's the center there and there. Okay, so these four. Okay. So we can get rid of this now. Alright. So, two snow. And the rest of the snow goes up like this. Then, we can do the outline first. That might be a good idea. Hope this looks good. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, and as I said, if it doesn't look good, we're going with just a pattern, nice looking pattern on the ground. There we go. Let's take a step back. Okay, so I found the center of the I did. Why does it look like it's not centered anymore? It isn't. I did it wrong. 1, 2. Yeah, this is wrong. Did I count wrong here? Right. 1, 2, 3. What did I do wrong? 1, 2, 1, 2. This should be one farther down. It should be like this. But I thought I counted correctly. We'll fill in everything except for this, I guess. It should be like this. But I'm sure I counted. Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah. So maybe, you know what it is? 1, 2, 1, 2. Yeah. I put in extra snow. That's the problem. So really, this shouldn't be here, actually. Oh, no, wait. Disaster. Wasn't using a shovel. So this is the problem. We're gonna fill it all in as best we can first, and then we'll. So that's the top. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Just like that. Now it should be centered. Yes, okay. Next we're going to use the light gray. Let's clear out the blocks in the middle. Let's get a little bit more coal. Not too much though. And we're going to do the light gray. Oh wait. No, light gray is the darker color. Sorry. A little confusing because, you know, light. This makes it sound like it should be the lighter color, but actually white wool is obviously lighter, so just go like that. This should go oh, right, yeah, no, this shouldn't be here. Damn, I don't really know if I like this. And I don't think that fixing the snow is going to really help. If I use fortune pick, because you don't get it unless it's a shovel, I don't think it's going to work, but... Yeah, okay, I have to go back anyways. Alright, damn. Alright, here's the deal. Alright, I'm gonna try it again. Or not try it again, I'm gonna go get some snow. I'm going to... Before I do that... I think this episode should be over soon anyway, so let me just round these corners out a little bit. And then I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to probably coat around here with these stone half slabs again. And then we'll see. I'm thinking potentially take that. Take all this. Still kind of stocking up on iron because used so much of it doing the top of the daylight detector. But then I'm thinking we're going to look here and see what it looks like and potentially just fill in the rest of the floor with these half slabs. But I think definitely probably another stripe, so to speak. Not a stripe, but a little strip of smooth stone probably right here, and then we'll make the executive decision about the ghast tier, and that will be the end for today. I do have more smooth stone half slabs, so no fear there. I will get you when I have done, or I will get back to you when I'm done with all that. Alright guys, I had the idea of looking at it from up here and I think it looks great. I think that's a pretty good representation of a ghast here. I really like it. I'm really happy with the way that came out, but I'm still not sure on the relevance of a ghast tier. So, yeah, I don't really know. With the stripes going along, not stripes, I keep calling them that, with the pattern on the floor, if it got so that there was kind of like a small box around it, and I figured that there was not going to be anything that looked any better other than just filling it in with the smooth stone slabs, and I like the way that turned out. So... I'm going to leave the gas tier for now because I'm happy with the way it turned out. Perhaps we could tie in some other things. I don't know. I'm trying to think about how we can make the gas tier relevant, and if we could somehow theme this village around the ghast or the nether or potion making. A thought occurred to me in the railway system. Perhaps a different each stop in the railway system could be another, like potion making item or something like that. You know, like the gas tier item, the spider eye stop. The gas tier stop would be here. You know, maybe in the tree farm it could be the seed stop. Because seeds are another easy one to make, I assume, with green and lime green wool. But anyways, so I think that's a nice floor. I'm going to keep it. Let me know what you think about the gas tier. It occurred to me it could be a slime ball. But I don't know if slime balls is any more relevant at all. So... yeah, the other thing is we could make it a tier, the tier shape, because it fits and it looks nice, and change the color to blue and have it be a water droplet, or green and have it be something else, or red and have it be, oh, red, that could be cool, because then it could be like the blood palace or something. I feel like that red is a royal color, palace is for royalty, etc. So that's great. And this is the end of this episode. Next time, we'll see how it looks from down here. I don't like it as much from down here because can't get an overhead look of the whole gas tier thing. It's confusing as to what it is. But anyways, next time we will be working, probably don't need this anymore. Next time we will be working on the, ceiling. I'm probably gonna do, or I will be doing, a check to see exactly how many blocks I'm going to need, blocks of gold, that is, for the ceiling. And then we will do that, and I will also go strip mining before then to get enough gold, and then we will be able to put that on there in a pyramid formation and see how it looks. And if that goes really smoothly as this went, but with less time, then we might be able to start working on that inner ring I was talking about, as well as maybe some lighting for this place, which I have some interesting ideas about. So, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please show some support. I really appreciate it. And stay tuned for progress on this, as well as... other projects. I've been trying to see if I can get away from working on the palace all the time. It's kind of hard though, seeing as the village is the only thing I have going right now. Trying to change that, as I just said though, so hopefully that will change and we will be able to get some variety in these videos, and then you know, once this is done, I will be forced to have variety in the videos because I have other things to attend to. But honestly, recording these videos makes them a lot funner to play. So, thank you again for making it more fun to play. And as always, thanks for watching. So, I will be seeing you, I hope, on the next episode.